In this video, we will be instructing how to create a C-Pulley system for crevasse rescue. Here we have a three-man rope team climbing up the Snoqualmie Resort Glacier. As the three climbers are climbing along, one of the team members falls into a crevasse and yells, "Falling!" The other two team members immediately go into the rest position and kick their feet into the snow, making sure that the weight of their upper body is over the axis such. The lead climber and the middle climber communicate with each other to see what's going on. The middle climber communicates with the fallen climber to see if they are in need of rescue. In this scenario, they are in need of rescue. The lead climber checks with the middle climber to see that they have the weight, and then slowly gets up, ready to go back into the rest position if she slips. The lead climber slowly walks toward the middle climber, pulling slack out of his harness prusik and probing for crevasses. When he's near them, he walks around and below the middle climber about 6 feet to set up the initial ice axe anchor. The climber manages the slack that he just brought with him, throwing it to the side. Or at least trying to. The lead climber attaches his hero loop to the fallen climber's rope using a prusik hitch. He cleans it and tests it to make sure that it slides and bites properly. He then grabs a single runner from his harness and girth hitches it to the shaft of his ice axe. The lead climber plants his axe at about a 20-degree angle away from the fallen climber's rope. Ideally, you would like the head of the axe to be against the snow, but in this case, it was early season and we hit dirt. So the runner was then moved close to the ground as not to leverage the axe out of the snow. And the runner is attached to the hero loop using a non-locking carabiner that's positioned up and away from the fallen climber. He slides the hero loop toward the fallen climber in order to transfer the load from the middle climber to the initial ice axe anchor, and then places his uphill foot on the runner in front of the ice axe in order to guard it. From here on, the ice axe must always be guarded. Next, he communicates with the middle climber to let them know that it's safe to stand up. She's prepared to go back into the arrest position if the anchor were to fail. She takes a picket with a double runner girth hitched to the middle hole and attaches a carabiner if there's not already one on there. She then determines the picket placement by measuring with the runner length from the hero loop at a 45-degree angle. After determining where the picket needs to be placed, she digs a trench at minimum 12 inches deep, deeper if the snow is unconsolidated. And then digs a trench for the runner, creating a T-shape. Both climbers are careful not to disturb the snow in front of the picket. Now she can bury the picket into the trench and attach it to the hero loop, being sure to place the double runner underneath the rope. Again, the carabiner should be facing up and away from the fallen climber. Now the climber buries the picket by stomping the snow from behind the picket, being sure not to disturb the snow in front of the picket. The middle climber then personal anchors into a single strand of the bomber anchor using a locking carabiner, making sure to place her personal anchor underneath the rope. And then she can come completely out of the system. The lead climber pulls the slack out of the rope through his harness prusik. The lead climber then ties a figure eight on a bite on the rope above the hero loop. And attaches it to the two non-locking carabiners attached to the hero loop using a locking carabiner. The middle climber then passes their ice axe to the lead climber to take with them to the lip of the crevasse. And then they carefully switch off ice axe guarding duties. The lead climber self-belays with their prusik down the rope to the crevasse lip, probing with their ice axe for safety. The lead climber would then make contact with the fallen climber to assess their condition and make sure that they would be able to attach a pulley to their belay loop. Next, the lead climber slides the ice axe underneath the fallen climber's rope to protect the lip of the crevasse, and then buries the ice axe leash into the snow to protect the axe from falling into the crevasse. The lead climber then removes his kiwi coils. And removes his butterfly tie and knot. Here, rope management is very important. He creates hand coils from his tie-in point, leaving enough slack to lower a pulley to the fallen climber. He attaches a pulley to the slack side of the rope with a locking carabiner. If the fallen climber were actually in a crevasse, he would carefully lower the pulley to the fallen climber, but in this case, he just flings it at his face. The fallen climber attaches the pulley to their belay loop using the locking carabiner. The lead climber uses their harness prusik to self-belay back to the anchor area while releasing their hand coils. The lead climber then attaches their personal anchor to a single strand of the dead man anchor. Again, making sure that the personal anchor is underneath the rope. The lead climber then unclips his prusiks but leaves them on the rope. Next, they are going to set up a hauling backup, also known as a progress capture. The middle climber takes a double runner and attaches it to the two anchor carabiners using a locking carabiner. The middle climber then passes the lead climber their hero loop, who prusik hitches it to the hauling rope. He attaches the hero loop to the double runner using a locking carabiner. Now it's time to haul. The lead needs to feed the rope through the hero loop prusik as they haul on the rope so that no slack builds up. And does the progress capture work? Yeah, it does. They'll resume hauling on the rope and continue until the fallen climber is safely out of the crevasse.